Kevin's shoulder. Hey, everybody at home. It's the new year, and that means there are tons of new gadgets to talk about.
And joining us once again, fresh off his trip to the Consumer Electronics Show, please welcome back to the show the Gadget Guy and host of the world-famous game show, What the Heck Is That?, Steve Greenberg. Hey, Steve.
Hey, how you doing? Thanks for having me on. And yeah, I did the show this year remotely. I didn't go to Vegas like a lot of other folks. It was sort of a hybrid show this year. I hope next year to be back in person. But yeah, you can still get a lot of the information offline. There were tons of press events and whatnot. So I brought a couple ideas along from the Consumer Electronics Show for you guys.
Yeah, I wanted to ask about it being a more of a virtual experience. You kind of mentioned that, but were you sad? Was it still like the same level of excitement about things?
I literally was planning to go until like the day before, and then just a whole bunch of my meetings had all canceled and some other things had started canceling, and the people I was expecting to see there weren't going to be there. I said, you know what? I'm not going to do it. I just basta, I give up. And I just figured next year I'll go. So last year was all virtual and was sort of spotty. This year was sort of a hybrid. I'm hoping next year we'll be back in person. But there's still a lot of great information. And really, it's about the innovation that comes out of the show, not the actual show.
Well, Steve, you are the gadget guy, of course. So let's get into it. What do we have here? I mean, the first thing I'm looking at, the Philokwa Connect. Is that what we've got?
This is the world's first smart water bowl for a cat. So how the cat would use it. Here's a crop.
Oh my god!
Right here. How it's used it. Now you're thinking, why do we need a smart watering bowl for a cat? Well, it's actually pretty simple. There's a microchip in most cats. This keeps track of how often, how much, and when they drink. Then by doing that, you can see if, especially in an older or middle-aged cat, if their habits change, their drinking habits change, you need to alert a veterinarian. This can actually monitor up to 32 cats. And of course, that begs the question.
I'm sorry, what?
Why do you have 32 cats?
Is this a hoarding situation? 32 cats?
I'm a little worried about that. And of course, the other question after this, what do you do if you have 33 cats? But that's another story. But it's a pretty cool from the folks at Sure Pet Care. This cat right here seems to like it a lot.
How many cats equal one guard dog?
I don't know.
Oh, I would say when you hit 33, you're certainly, you know.
That's enough?
You're well covered.
Okay.
Yeah.
Right, that's good.
Okay, the next one also, I was very curious what this could be. OWC Mini Stack STX or Sticks.
So this is really important if you do a lot of video editing, audio editing, photography. This is really cool because it's the first hub and storage system combined that is also Thunderbolt 4 certified technology. So if you work in that world, you'll know how important this is. This is from maxsales.com. Brand new, first time it's out. It's literally stackable. You can have a bunch of these units on top of each other. And it's absolutely a game changer in that world. So it was made a big announcement at the show.
Steve, this next one, I have a suspicion as to what it's going to be, the Cradle Block and Talk. Walk me through this.
So we all are worried that our phones are eavesdropping on our calls or those apps are eavesdropping on us. This is a charging dock that actually stops your phone from listening. So you put your phone in there and then it will block the sound so it can't hear what's going on. But if you say, Pazio, stop, then it will give you a 30-second window where you can ask the weather or how old Betty White was or whatever the question is that's coming up on your mind. You can then ask it and you get the answer. So basically, it's like the cone of silence, remember from the Get Smart days, for your smartphone, which I think a lot of people feel they need, from a company called Pazio.com.
Interesting. So it can sort of be like in an Alexa, as in you can turn it on with a voice activation, but otherwise it's totally muting everything out.
Right. So people feel, and there's some truth to it, that your phone is constantly listening to you and your apps on the phone are listening to you. So this way, you're guaranteed when it's sitting there in your home, it's not listening to you, except when you give it that little window when you say Pazio, stop.
Interesting. Okay, nanotech organolite batteries.
So you know when you go to the airport, they always ask you, do you have a lithium battery in your suitcase? The reason they're asking you that question is because lithium batteries can be explosive. So they're potentially dangerous. So this was kind of a test they did at the show comparing lithium ion batteries to nanotech organolite batteries. And in the test, they basically drilled a drill through a lithium ion, boom, it exploded. They put lithium ion in a lot of heat, boom, it exploded. When they did the same abuses to a nanotech organolite battery, no problem. So the takeaway is that I think in the not too distant future, you're going to see lithium ion batteries disappearing and nanotech organolite or some other battery taking its place in the not too distant future.
Steve, real quick, one more. The yummy future robot.
This is what robots always catch my imagination. I like this one because it's actually working now. This is the yummy future. And this is a one-armed wonder that's sort of like a barista. It can make drinks, bring snacks over. There's a whole bunch of stuff about 5 times faster than a person can do it. It's actually going to be working in a coffee house in Champaign, Illinois in 6 weeks.
Wow.
So it's not like, you know, on the drawing board. It's a real thing. And I think it's just kind of cool. And yummy future. What a great name.
So when my high school math teacher told me they're going to take our jobs, I'm telling you, the robots are going to take the jobs.
He was right.
Are you kidding?
Yeah. I mean, anyone who's seen a Terminator movie knows there's reason to be worried. So yeah, he was right.
Gosh, he retired shortly after that. I got to find out what he's doing. Well, smart guy.
Yeah. Stick around, everybody. We're going to have more with Steve when we come back. They are going to take our jobs. You and I are going to be done here.
Welcome back. He's the host of What the Heck Is That? And he's the gadget guy. And he's right here. He's Steve Greenberg. Hey.
Hey.
Okay, hey. We've got our next thingamajig, as I would like to call it, the Samsung Eco Remote.
Okay, well, this is not it, but this is something for it. It basically looks a lot like this. It's a remote control. That part isn't cool. But what is cool, first of all, it's made from recycled materials, which, of course, is very nice.
Yeah.
But what's really cool is it doesn't need a battery. This remote from Samsung actually uses the electricity that's inside your Wi-Fi signal. So right now in all of our homes, we have these Wi-Fi signals bouncing around, being used or not used. But inside those signals, there's actually energy. And this remote can suck it down and charge itself based using that.
Wow.
So it's a very cool thing. And by the way, in the future, they say that's how we're going to power all of our stuff. The energy is actually going to be pumped in through a signal rather than putting on top of something or putting a battery in it. That'll all be passe in the future. This remote is the first step into that future charging world.
Well, and this might be a very obvious question, but does that affect then your Wi-Fi signal in your house?
Not at all, because it's all this wasted Wi-Fi energy that's bouncing around my apartment right now and your studio right now. It's just, you know, it gets used when it gets used, but there's a lot of excess energy in it. Well, this remote has a little absorber for that, and it sucks it down. A remote doesn't need too much power, so it's able to work on it. But it's a hint of what's to come in the not-too-distant future.
Way of the future, according to Steve. Absolutely. And I think he's right. That absolutely is going to be the way of the future. Steve, tell me about the Orbisk food waste analysis. What is that?
Well, I'm kind of an environmentally savvy guy, and this is called Orbisk, and it's a device that goes right over the trash that monitors how much a restaurant throws out. You just kind of show the plate and then dump it in there. And it does an analysis of what's being thrown out, what's not being thrown out, and then it can help restaurateurs and chefs order. It can actually help them be more sustainable and how to reduce wasted food. They can see on Tuesdays and Thursdays, you know, the shrimp doesn't go, you know, goes like crazy, you know, gets thrown out like crazy. So they can actually calculate a better menu and be more profitable, more sustainable moving to the future by monitoring that food waste.
You know, I could have saved them a lot of money because they could have just hired my dad, who every single day said, "We don't throw food away," and we never would have food wasted at all in our household. Could have saved them a lot of money just by hiring my dad.
Yeah, I'm starting to think that we might be brothers because that was my dad related? Too.
See, I think so. You heard it all too growing up. We don't throw food.
Not throw away. Clean plate club. Yep, clean plate club. That's
100% correct, Steve. You are absolutely right.
We are sticking with food. Skippy food delivery happening here in the Twin Cities too?
Yes, this is a story that's close to your home. It's called Skippy. He's a food delivery robot. And this robot is pretty cool besides looking cute. He's refrigerated or heated, and he can pick up food from a restaurant and deliver it to a home. He's controlled by virtual reality goggles and artificial intelligence.
Wow.
He's actually already being used right now in St. Paul, and he's coming to Minneapolis later this year. So this is a piece of technology right in your backyard. So be on the street looking for Skippy.
Wow.
Are you kidding me? I mean,
wow.
I have so many questions about how Skippy works, but I want to get to the game instead.
This is what I've been waiting for.
Yeah,
game time.
Pierre is our sports guy. You don't know this, Steve, but he's our sports guy, so he's a little competitive, a little into sports.
Love games.
I mean, and I just want to win. So that's all there is to that. We're going to play a little bit of What the Heck Is That? Go.
Okay, here we go. Take a look at the product.
Okay.
Here it is. Take a look at it. I'm telling you right now, it's not for storage. It's got these holes on the front of it. It's got a little vent action down here. But what the heck is that?
I know. You can guess first, Pierre.
I think that might have something to do with some kind of like solar plant growing device in a Tupperware.
Nope, that's not the right.
Okay, this is my guess, and it's an educated guess because our executive producer Jeff may or may not have this.
Cheated.
Is it a pasta? Does it have to do with boiling pasta?
It is.
I saw what you did. Jeff.
Look at that. We're a team here.
So the way it works, as Jeff will tell you, and I can tell you the same thing because I make my pasta this way, you put the pasta in here, but first you use these holes to measure, you know, how much pasta you want for, you know, two servings or one serving. You fill up the water to a certain line, you pop it in the microwave. When it's finished, about 12 minutes, you drain it out like that, and then you've got some really great pasta. I think it's super easy, especially if you're, you know, at work or something when you don't have a stove handy. Check it out, Pasta Pasta. And again, the show is called What the Heck Is That? And people can get to it by going to gadgetgameshow.com. And this one here, you know the answer. It's episode 43. So you're ahead of the panelists right now.
Noted, so I can cheat somewhere else too.
Yeah.
Hey, Steve, before you go, since Jason isn't here, I would feel really bad asking this, not asking this. Are you in New York or Florida?
I'm in Florida, and as Jason would always want me to do, and in honor of Jason, I'm going to show you the view.
Oh, God.
Please, look at that.
Bravo, Steve.
Hey, man.
It's gorgeous. But don't worry, in a couple of days, I fly back to New York, and I'll be freezing just like you guys.
Thank you.
But right now, I'm enjoying the warm weather.
Will you enjoy?
Steve, we've had a lot of fun with you. Thank you so much for coming on the show with us today.
And to watch the award-winning TV show, go to, as he said, Gadget Game Show. There it is.
There it is.
.com.
What the heck is it? Go to gadgetgameshow.com. And please like and subscribe. Come on. Help me help you. Come on.
Like, subscribe, do the whole nine yards. Thank you, Steve. We'll be right back, everybody.